Eagle.
Give me a prediction in the pistol round.
Well, obviously, Astralis have got the bomb down great positions here. Cajun's going to be catching off one player. So it seems like Astralis are going to be looking good. But actually, as I say that, Method, two players come in with a kill each, and now they've got to go for the retake. But Device still shutting down one in connector. He hasn't finished off this kill. He needs to hurry up and get back to his teammate over on the bomb site. He's going to go for the jump shot. Waterfalls will go down, and the defuse is already in play. So Ubique holding this off with his teammate, and this defuse should come in. And it's going to be stuck here a few more seconds. And there we go. Method securing that pistol round there. So very good play from the Rustonians.
Yeah, that's exactly what I mentioned just when we went live with the game, that in those situations where you are down two men compared to your opponent, somebody has to step up and then turn it around. And Astralis had numerous guys do that.
Yeah.
Like you said, Dupree with a random double kill, or then it was Device, or then it was Zippix, or anyone, right?
Yeah.
And now we finally see Method winning a round where it didn't look too promising.
Yeah, so they've pretty much been guaranteed. Obviously, Astralis got the bomb down, so they've been pretty much guaranteed two rounds if Astralis don't do that. Dupree finding that headshot. So
he Method, did it on Mirage already.
Yeah, Method should be able to pick this up fairly convincingly. Obviously, no armor on Astralis is going to be a problem. Even if they do secure a couple of rifles, they will struggle. And if we look at the bets again, as we saw, you know, everyone hedging their bets on Astralis, rightly so after that previous performance here. So obviously, Method with a nice start, winning the pistol round,
yeah.
And then obviously they've got a plenty of P90s and SMGs here to shut down the non-armored players. Should be good just for the next round, so they can pretty much guarantee two rounds on the board if Astralis don't go nuts, and that would be, you know, instantly the amount of rounds they got in the whole game last
but
match.
If Astralis gets the bomb down, if they pick up two or let's say even three more frags, this could be horrible for Method. The Danes could actually have a better economy in the upcoming round if that happens. Mm. The CTs, however, they still have the four men. Let's see what Astralis is going to be doing about
what
that.
What is he doing?
Look at that. I mean, just a tiny pixel sticking out, and that's enough for him to get the kill. Ubique with a straight reply, and that was really important for Method. But the pressure's on for the Russian squad.
But now Astralis are a man up. They're going to be pushing into the site, but Fetch does not want anyone to come out alive here. He's going to pick a double kill, but Zifnix and Cajun also chiming in. And now it's all on UB, because I was saying Method should have this round. Astralis have pulled something out of nothing, and they've done extremely well here. And Ubique has got to hurry up with this one versus two retake. The time is ticking, and he's going to go down. Cajun finishing him off. And I think one of the main issues going into that round was after Dupree got that 1D go over on short, you could see Method was scared. Even though Astralis had no armor, they backed off. They backed all their players off, and they allowed, I think it was Cajun, to pick up that FAMAS over on short. They weren't challenging for it. One of the two rifles they had on the whole team, and they just go, Astralis, take it. We're scared of you guys.
Yeah.
And that was a huge issue for them, obviously, because Astralis, you could see Cajun, even though getting the final kill with that, allowed them to get onto the B bomb site. So Method playing a little bit too passive there. I think they should have tried to challenge for the equalization of the amount of players left. But regardless, Astralis going for the buy, as well as Method, they're going to be filing straight into the B site. Device going to be picking up a double kill, and Method are already two men down.
Indeed, the CT's completely out of position. The terrorists already have everything checked out. The bomb just gets carried in, and Cajun B saves the back as well. He's having an eye out for his teammates over there, and he can be the lurker that comes in later on in the round to maybe, if it comes down to a clutch, to maybe still take it home for the terrorists. But the CT's are backing away. They have heavily invested in this round, and they want to take everything back, and they want to reset and try in the next round. Cajun B doesn't allow that to happen for Fates, but Ubique drops him, and that is a rifle on the loose for Waterfalls to be picked up.
Yeah,
there
so
it goes.
They're going to try and save these rifles. Obviously, Dupree is going to want to challenge us. He doesn't want them to get anything, because obviously next round's going to be an eco. So I can imagine either they're going to buy up three players with Waterfalls and Ubique, which is unlikely, or they're going to eco the remaining three players, which would be a better call from Method, at least to pick up some kind of CT economy to work with. And they're going to try and save this. Obviously, Astralis doesn't want anything to come out of this, and it seems like there's going to be a better challenge here over towards Party. But oh, Zifnix just finding that kill in the last second of the round there. Waterfall going down. So only one rifle is saved for Method now. So they're definitely not going to be buying up with that singular rifle.
No, I don't think so either. It would be almost suicidal for their economy if they did so. On the other side, we have Astralis turning that not so good start on the pistol into their own favor. And as you can see, you're completely right. Only two P250s bought up for Fates and Chetty, the two Estonian players.
That timing, though, this is just Counter-Strike in its finest. Cajun just changing weapon as Waterfall peeks into connector. But obviously, he's got that information now. And we're going to see Astralis attempt to push onto the B site here. We do see a bit of a triple stack from Method. So it's going to be holding it off quite well. But Zyphix is going to come in with the MP9, sorry, and pick up a kill. Fetch now last alive over on the B site. Going to be finished off too. So two players remaining here for Method. It's just going to be a bit of a cleanup from Astralis. Basically, no weapons for the CTs here, so it should be fairly easy for them to get out of this alive. And Device, look at that, 3 HP just running away. Waterfalls isn't going to be able to grab that kill, which is very unlucky. You know, he could have at least tried to do some economical damage there. And
instead, well, he picked up the Famas.
Yeah, he could try and do something with the Famas, but they know his position, and they're going to convert on him very shortly here. Oh.
Ah, wow. Two players on 3 and 6 HP on Zyphix. Astralis still making it happen. 3-1. Now we see the CTs back on rifles, and this is going to be crunch time for the Estonians here. Already partying in CT spawn, warming up their wrists for this important round.
Yeah, warming up their wrists for this beating they're about to receive from Astralis as they buy up full AKs here, no AWP on Device, and head straight towards the B site. Three players pushed in towards it. One is also coming through connector, so he can get right in there and deep. And we've also got a player over in courtyard holding the flank, so no one's coming from there. And Dupree's going to be the first to lead the charge. So they just wait for the smokes to dissipate from Method. Or, you know, they could always run through it, but I don't think that'd be a good idea here from Astralis. Just want to keep their economy high and go into this round with a positive mindset. But Chetty's already tagged. 10 HP on the CT there, so Astralis already done some early damage here. But they're going to return it. Device, 17 HP after he receives a nice little warbang there. And now the HP is equalized, but the equipment is definitely in the favor of Astralis here.
A cheeky nade there by Device, but doesn't connect. The CTs didn't go for any aggression on bathrooms, and we have to keep an eye out on that one. Astralis was taking it into consideration. They held defensively with Cajun B and Kerrigan being at playground even, and the statue, the fountain. So they were very deep out of the A-bomb set. And now Kerrigan is racing down A long. They could try and get a fake go in the CTs. Let's see what they are doing about that. They will react to that one Molotov Kerrigan tossed, but not really. I thought that Fates could go for a rotation or an over-rotation in that sense, but they won't. Shetty stays in position, goes down to Zyphix already, Fates with the trade frag. It's the CTs losing man after man as Zyphix and Kerrigan chime in with the frags. Ooh. Now it's Fates with the triple kill. He makes it another one. He makes it a 1v1. Kerrigan in B-short. He comes into the bomb site. The bomb has been dropped with 10 seconds, and Fates is having the jump on the Danish in-game leader. Method gets that round thanks to the overperformer, so to speak.
Yeah, 1v3 there, I think that was. Very good play from the CT. Method picking up a second round, but they've just got to worry about not getting reset here. Astralis obviously have the economy to rebuy for another one, so they'll be going up for the full rifles. Maybe an AWP as well, yep, on Device. Also, recently, Device, if I'm correct, has switched to the AWP instead of Kerrigan. I might be correct on reading that. I think Kerrigan is now giving the AWP full-time to Device, so it's not just Device picking up every now and then. Like,
I think it still depends on.
Yeah, it depends on the situation, the map, how it's working. Double AWP obviously will be Kerrigan and Device if they do so. But Device has been AWPing an awful lot lately, and it's been working out very well for Astralis. And we're going to see them go up towards the A site. Four players here. Zyphix is going to be over towards B, just holding for the aggression from Method so they can't get any flank. But a good position in the smoke there. That's going to be Chetty over towards B short, so you can easily catch them off guard if they come out of connector, because obviously they'll have no idea he's there. And Cajun setting up the smokes.
Yeah, Method have the Mac 7, so that it goes to show their economy is far from good at the moment. They really need to pick up this round as flawlessly as possible. They have three defenders on the A-bomb, so they initially only had two, and I was a little bit scared for them. Now it's Astralis getting the chokehold. They spray down those angles, and KGB gets a frag through the smoke. Fates retaliates, and once again it's Fates to step it up. You beak with the famous frag. He comes out of the smoke, blazing gun in hand. 1v4 now, Device is on his own, the bomb is ticking. He's got the smoke still in place, he's getting tagged from all the different directions, and Jimka will finish the job. Method with the third round.
Ubeek as well, very key player there, just jumping straight through the smoke and picking up that double kill. They weren't expecting that in any way. A very good round from Method, actually securing another on the board. So they're actually keeping up this time. You know, we did say that, or at least you did say that you'd imagine Method would do a little better this map.
Yeah.
They did struggle on Mirage, picking up a bit of confidence maybe going into this round. They've secured a 3-3 scoreline now. So obviously Astralis are going to get the bomb down, so they should be able to buy up here if I'm correct. And yeah, it appears they will. No AWP just yet on device, but the rest of them full rifles, plenty of nades, and no worries with armor either.
But Waterfalls has the orb, and he's going to have an impact, either a positive or a negative impact for Method. If he gets that control play on A, and Astralis have to give the CT some more slack for their performance. You know, they have to realize, okay, they are not doing bad. They will punish us for small mistakes. Then we could see Waterfalls take the space the terrorists give them. And look at that. Jimka up to the challenge. KGB was boosted up, but didn't get anything done over there.
Yeah, but of course he opened multiples. Even if he does take out a solitary A player, you know, on a lurk or whatever that Astralis might set up, it's still very key because, of course, it will stop any kind of fake that Astralis wants to set up towards the A site. Fakes just being flashed through the smoke there. We'll go down to 2-3. So unlucky position, giving away the advantage there, in fact, to a 5-4, now to a 4-4. So unlucky there for the Estonian. And again, 4-4. Still a few smokes and nades left on Astralis, so they should be able to get onto the site. But Method have plenty of defending nades. You know, two players still with full nades. And oh, Waterfall, as you said, he may have an impact. He definitely had a positive impact there. Turning it into a 3-on-4 and giving Method the advantage that they lost once again. And now Astralis committing to this B site.
Oh, Jetty goes down straight away. Device with the AK headshot. 3v3. The terrorists are in the site already. Jimka has to step up for his squad to have a chance here. Smoke spray is unsuccessful, as well as Ubique smoke spray didn't connect to anything. Neither is the crosshair placement of Ubique. Finally gets a frag, but Device quickly trades that back. 2v2. Dupree makes it a 2v1 man advantage for the terrorists.
The double D's are still in action, and Waterfall is going to have a trouble here trying to pick either of them up. He goes for the AWP shot, but he's going to be finished off there. So Astralis picking up a fourth round, and again, the economy going back and forth between both teams. You know, winning and losing rounds is not going to be helping the CTs at all, whereas the T's are prevailing, in fact. Getting these bomb plants and winning the rounds, obviously, is very important. Look at that shot from Waterfall. Such a key shot. Yeah. There we go. Second time lucky. And third time lucky, or not so lucky, just
well, it was forth. Just that millisecond reaction, right?
Yeah, very fast. And obviously very key in trying to bring Method back into the round. However, yeah, they don't prevail. And Method going to be on a bit of a quasi-buy here. Two players going for the almost full eco. Waterfall just with a PT-50 and Jimka not buying anything at all. But the rest of them, some armor, some pistols. Got a couple of deagles there as well, which is fun to see. We're going to see Cajun find the first frag of the round. So that's the armorless player. Waterfall's going down, and Jibka also picking up a frag as well. So securing an AK there. He's going to be challenged. He's going to find another, but we also see a couple of players going down from Method here. So it's already a 2-2 in favor of Astralis, obviously, having the equipment.
Yeah, but good job by Method to keep themselves alive here and to keep them challenging Astralis. Because if they stop challenging the Danes now, they will start getting the confidence back they had on Mirage, and then they will simply pummel them. Dupree, can you do that? Yeah, that was Jimka just trying, but the lack of armor and the aim punch kicking in made it almost impossible.
And also the aggressive post-plant position. The bomb is planted over towards Short. He runs into Bank, and now it's all on Chetty. 1-2 here, he will go down to Carrigan. But again, yeah, that position from Dupree, very clever, because obviously Method aren't going to be expecting it. With a short plant, you usually put both players either towards long or short. But instead, Dupree just pushes into Bank, and they weren't expecting that at all. And obviously, that was key to Astralis winning that round. 5-3 now, and we're going to see Method finally go for the buy-up once again.
Yeah, Astralis is back on the steering wheel, but maybe they can lose grip again. We will see. I wouldn't call Method down and out yet, even though the five rounds for Astralis are looking quite strong at the moment. But the CTs have the AWP back, they are back with equipment, and they are taking some control on A as well. So they seem to be a little more confident.
Yeah, definitely true, and Method just playing more passive positions here. You can see they're playing almost for a retake on the B site. One player deep by barrels, and the rest of them just holding out towards CT spawn here. So trying to have all their players alive so they can commit to a retake if Astralis do take the site. And Ubique is going to be huge, HMB shutting him down over in connector, and now no refrag is coming out from Method. Bit of a bomb spot over towards B there. They've got that information, and Zipix is also going to pick out Jimka. So 5-3 now on Device. Trying to get another AWP. He's going to be challenged, going for the double kill, actually only landing one pick, going down, and now it's all on the shoulders of Waterfalls, but he's also being finished off. Another 1-1 engagement going in the favor of Astralis.
Sometimes, you know, you look at the players, or the observer switches to the player, and you see he's reloading his gun, and then the next moment somebody shows up, and you're like, oh, sad.
Yeah.
Really unlucky timing for you. And That was Astralis just keeping the trading game, winning the duels, and just making that push happen. So Method might lose grip here. They are definitely on a slippery slope on the CT side, about to lose complete control over their economy. They're back on a save, and now it's Astralis. You can see it, how they play it already. They have a Mech 10 for Dupree, for example. Everyone's running. Nobody's sneaking anymore. And yeah, the frags will happen as well.
Yeah, of course. Method have nothing to lose. They're going to be playing aggressive positions here. But good management of the economy by Astralis, giving Dupree this Mach 10, knowing that Method are going to be on eco there after getting reset. So having that information at least that they are not going to have any armor means they can buy up their Mach 10 and therefore pick up $600 a kill. So that's very good for Dupree. He's also going to be buying up an AK this round, knowing they're on a buy round, not wanting to get too overconfident and cocky there. Now Method are going to be up on a buy, and if you just look at the faces of Method when the camera switches to them, they really don't look happy with this. I just saw someone facepalm, so they're not looking at least confident about this match, whereas Astralis, usual, calm and collected.
Indeed. 12 kills at the moment for Dupree. Once again, top fragging. He's being monstrous lately. He's been like that for a long, long time already, but I think he found a way to elevate his game even further. And Method has to elevate their game as well. Yubik is not able to get that first spray down, and he tried to reset his aim, but that is not going to work against Astralis. They're too quick to capitalize on the slightest mistakes. Waterforce is going to be the next in line. He's got support with Jimka just around the corner. And Astralis is attacking the A-bomb site straight forward. No real delay, just checking the corners, getting in position, and then getting ready for the execution.
Exactly so, and being a man up gives Astralis such a huge advantage going towards this A site. We are going to see obviously aggressive positions coming up from KGB here. And, oh, device, very nice position, boosted up on top of this flower plant. Flower pot is going to be ready to probably kill over towards the A site, but the double molly is going to be inbound, and it's going to hold back Method from over peaking. Of course, you know, the smoke coming from the Molotov is going to block their view as well, so it's difficult to even get them information.
Yeah.
Astralis are getting aggressive, and the smoke's finally committing, and the flashes. This take is perfect for Astralis. They know what they're doing. Cajun giving the refrag. Look at that one tap, taking out Fates there, and now Waterfall's also being finished off, leaving the last alive man, Chetty, over towards B. Going to have to rotate through CT.
Yeah, I turn around instantly and just hide away in a corner, maybe try to drown in the sewers or something in that dirty water. But there is really no way that he can do anything about this round anymore. Yeah. The terrorists actually come his way already. Look at Sipix, he's sneaking through, or not really sneaking, but he's making his way to the B-bomb site. They expect Chetty to go for that save, but he refuses to go down, and finally it's Sipix shutting him down.
But just Astralis being so confident, even that flank from Sipix, you usually see, when you see a chasing team in that situation, they'll go, okay, what's the fastest route to get to him? Let's all rush down CT and kill him, because obviously they have the economy to do so. But instead, just the perfect team playing from Astralis, sending Sipix all the way back down connector into B, knowing that if they force him down out into the B site, Sipix can just get the flank kill, which is perfect.
Yeah.
They did lose two players in the process, but obviously their economy is strong enough to afford that at least, and it's better than allowing Method to have a gun and a possible opening into the C-co.
Indeed. Astralis now shut Method down. It's like at the start of the round, Method had it, and Method had a small glimmer of hope here. But this is just running out. It's just no luck anymore, not the right equipment, not the right weapons, not the right timing.
The reason doing so, I think, because Method, at an early stage in the game, you're going to be able to have a lot of impact on the economy. Right now, Astralis have built up such a big bank that they're not going to be worrying about probably for the rest of the half. Whereas early on, they were, you know, switching between Galils, AKs, and kind of low buys, force buys, that kind of stuff. So Method could kind of flip with it before they built up a nice bank. And now Astralis, as they built up a bank, has stopped Method completely from having any chance, because these full rifles are such a hard task for Method to overcome, really. And we're going to just see Yubik stuck alone now.
Yeah, with the P250 in hand, again, a situation where the hopes are not too high. Astralis is taking the time though, so they're not taking it too easily, you know. They check everything, they push together as well. They want to avoid losing more players than necessary. Yubik might sneak his one frag in here. He rushes through the smoke, but device is there, Tech 9 in hand. And Astralis, after some struggle at the start, they are finally gaining some strong foothold, and they are a team, they can manage that foothold as well.
Yeah.
We can see them just looking indifferent at the moment. They're just
They never show emotion.
Yeah, like machines sitting there doing their job. Well, Method is going for the double AWP setup. So we have a change in the CT setup. They tried it a few times. Now they realize, okay, our previous setups didn't work. Let's change it.
Maybe it'll work well for them, but Fetch is always almost going to go down instantly to Device. Oh, Dupree, sorry, picking up a double kill on Karrigan, also tuning in. So only the orcs left for Method here. They got to go huge with these. Jimker stuck alone on the B side. Lovely no scope. Zippix is going to go down, and now he's got the bomb in his hand, so he can back off and play that. Peeking into tunnel, he's going to go for the no scope, but Karrigan finishing him off. I only feel like if he zoomed in there, he easily could have got that kill.
Yeah.
Karrigan was not ready for that at all, and it's all going to be a Waterfalls, be hopping around Foon style, but it's going to be a player lying in wait here. Device just ready for that, and he's going to finish him off with a Tet 9, just to add insult to injury there. And Astralis, 10-3, going into the second last round of the first half.
Yeah, for a brief second I thought, what is Method doing there exactly? They peaked B short, one after another. Dupree wasn't even flashed.
They were trying to get a fast trade, and obviously didn't peak fast enough, but Dupree was just ready for that.
It was the attempt of a fast, but it was rather giving Dupree a fast double.
Yeah.
And then Chetty gets caught off guard on the outside of bathroom with no support at all.
No.
So that was an easy 5v2 already.
Yeah,
and then your players are on their own.
Yeah. Device doing a perfect flank there, just holding it off. Of course, he wouldn't have had much impact, but still, it just shows goes to show Astralis have very good positioning on this map here. We're already going to see the first kill come out from Jimka there, picking up Zippix. So that's an early frag over from the CTs there, and now we're up into an advantage, although that is going to be stopped instantly from Device using the AWP and taking them out. So we're back down to a 4v4, and not a lot of equipment on Method either. They're going to be going for this full B stack here, and some aggression towards A out connector. So Astralis have meanwhile taken the A side bomb down as well, and they're just going to be picking up the kills as they rotate over into A. They're just getting so aggressive, no one holding the bomb really too heavily, and just Waterfalls and Chetty left.
Yeah, the CTs had a trap in connector, but it wasn't sprung by Astralis.
No.
The dangers didn't walk in there. They realized the CTs are most likely not having too many guns. If they do anything, they are probably, look at Device just wrecking Chetty there. Realizing the CTs are probably going for some traps somewhere around, so they took their time again and they stayed away from that. It's just prone to be ambushed in those stairwells, in the staircase.
But double AWP again from Method, so they're going to see if they can try and do something with this. I think some early aggression would be good, some fast peeking up towards courtyard, may possibly get them an early frag, and then they can back off. And as long as they just stop getting traded out, because as soon as Method get the first frag, it's boom, it's instant trade from Astralis. And they need to get this kill. Look at this position for Waterfalls. He needs to get this kill, and instead of just re-challenging and re-peeking, he just needs to run away.
Yeah,
and he's going to get that tag.
That is a small step for one man, and not even a huge step for humanity, but the terrorists have their own double AWP setup, but it's gonna be shut down by Waterfalls, who gets the kill onto Device on long, making it a 4v5, or let's say a 3.5 against 4. Karrigan now makes it the 4-man on the CTs. Waterfalls is still around though, and he needs to be the stopping point for the terrorist advances.
He's going to be holding us off, smoked up in bank, and they're going to just push onto the site here. 3v3, and the rotate is coming in from Method here, so Jimka needs to do something with this AWP here. He does get the tag onto Cajuns with the edge of the truck, but still 50 HP left on him and the bomb. Look at it, it's dropped all the way towards long. They have to back all the way off. They could easily go for some kind of B take here, but really in this position, they need to send one player back to get it. And you can see that's exactly what they're going to be doing. Just, I think, Zippix going back to get that. Cajun's going to go down meanwhile on the site. They don't have all their players here, so this is an issue.
Yeah, and Waterfalls is wrecking them. Jimka chimes in with his first frag of the AWP, and Waterfalls with the third. So at least the last round of the half is on the board for Method. And you see that cheeky grin. They are a little more happy than they have been before, at least with their individual performance. Maybe you can see some more of that in the pistol.
Of course. Well, they've doubled their rounds from last map in only the first half as well. So there's always potential, but again, not their map pick, Astralis and map pick, so obviously a big advantage there. And obviously, this is a very key round earlier, seeing Waterfalls as well get that first pick was good for them, although they did lose a round in the end. And I love that one tap from Cajun.
That was so casual. Just, and then he almost followed it up. I mean, he would have gotten the frag if Device wouldn't have stepped in.
But straight into the pistol round on the second half, and we're going to see Meta going for the five armor here, very confident in that. No smokes or flashes needed. Maybe some kind of hint towards not having any setups on the T side of Overpass, which is very likely, of course. Many strategies based around having more than three of your default players. And they're going to be slowly progressing towards the A site, just gaining map control, playing a normal default here in Astralis. Obviously, as they do with aggressive positions, we just saw Device up towards A long there. So he's gained some information early, at least. But they can't imagine it's going to be an A take. They don't actually have any information on the positions of the T's just yet.
Yeah, and that's a big problem for Astralis at the moment. At least they have those three players inside the A bomb site, and usually that allows them to have a good crossfire. Device is behind the container, doesn't get that first, but Dupree, and you know how strong he is. Cajun chimes in, and Device is, well, it's only Jimka on his own on the fountain. The CTs have him cornered in already. Zipix is behind and makes him backflip.
Yeah, very good shot. And Astralis secure the pistol around there. So Method, unlucky getting shut down by the beast that is Device with that USB. And now they're going to be on the force buy, obviously. No point really ecoing, just getting nades for the fourth round. Just going to stick with these Tech-9s, this armor. Maybe a Deagle with some body armor could do some work as well. And try and get a bomb plant. That's the main thing.
Yeah, so the B bomb set should be the point of entrance for them. Or they are going to go for a smoke plant on A, but they don't have a smoke, so I don't know what their chances are going to be. At least they're looking for some frags and stairwell. Device is shutting that down, though, and the terrorist hopes of getting a plant are quickly diminished by the CT's actions.
Yeah, and Jinko going down on short as well, leaving just Chetty on a 1v5, but nothing's going to come out of that round. Absolutely destroyed by Astralis there. Method will be into a full eco, putting Astralis up to 14.
Yeah, Method, what are they going to do? They don't have any money. Astralis is going to make it 14-4 without real question.
Yeah, well, of course, we said that for Astralis, and they picked up the full eco on the second round of the first half. So who knows what could happen. Again, no deagles here, really, to get the opening kills like we saw Dupree get. But regardless, I wouldn't hedge my bets on Method picking too much out of this round. Maybe a kill up Mice. The Device is going to be called over and connect. Picking up one kill, but he needs support from his teammate Fast. Lovely play from Dupree. Going to come and join him to pick up the frags just to save his life. And Yubik, given his position over and mid, will also be finished off by Dupree with the Glock there. So Astralis, as we said, 14-4. And Method with their last chance in this map, going for the bye round.
Just a well-drilled Astralis team, having Device in stair, and then having two players close to him. As soon as he spots them, spots the terrorists approach him, he calls in already, and they come in to save him and keep him alive, which is a big factor for the CTs usually. Maybe not so much for Astralis in this matchup, but it could be Method, Russian-Estonian mixture with AKs now. And you never know if they hit the heads correctly. It could be troublesome for the CTs. Device, though, will already get the bomb dropped in playground.
He's going to go down, though, and now it's all going to be a 4v4 here. We can see an aggressive position from Dupree's all the way pushed up, and he's going to get that kill onto Waterfalls there, so that's very good. He's got position of the bomb plus the man advantage. He doesn't need to overpeak here, but he knows he's got the confidence, but oh, the confidence is not going to be good enough. Fetch is going to land that headshot onto him, and now we're down to a 3v3.
Zipix on the backstep already. They are cornering in the bomb carrier, but now they are split up. KGB is on his own. If the terrorists will dispose of him, they could have a good opening for A, but he doesn't allow that. Feeds goes down. The terrorists now could cut Cajun B off, but they decide against it. Yubik actually goes for Kerrigan now, but Kerrigan has a different angle. And unexpected angle for Yubik there is seeing the CT out in the open like that is very unusual.
Yeah, but the thing is, they were in a 3v3 Astralis there, and you usually see Astralis just back off and play more passive, try and get the pick when the terrorist tries to converge onto a site. But we saw Cajun B get aggressive towards long, knowing the bomb was there, knowing they'd be going to attempt to pick it up, and finding that frag, and then backing off. And that was perfect, because on paper, you shouldn't be doing that. You shouldn't be pushing in a 3v3 unless you know you have a teammate to support you, to trade you if you die. But Cajun B just doing such an unexpected move. You know, the player who took down had his knife out. So very good play by him there. Obviously securing them that round pretty much. And now we're going to see Meta just run straight onto the B side. But Astralis have got a four-man stack towards us, and this is going to be perfect. And Negev coming out from Dupree. He's going to pull up a double kill instantly, leaving all on Fetch there with this Galil just running up behind him, but finally being finished off. And Astralis securing the second map 16-4.
Yeah, 16-4. They doubled their efforts.
Always true.
Method got four rounds this time around, but Astralis weren't really giving too much to the Russian Estonian mixture, which you have to keep in mind. They had two stand-ins due to some visa problems. So everyone that just tuned in and thought, what is this? They qualified with a strong lineup that consists mostly of Russians, but sadly, this time around, they had to use two stand-ins, and that completely scatters everything.
Yeah. That's unlucky. Of course, I wouldn't think they'd be managing to beat Astralis in a best of three, even with their full lineup.
Maybe, take a map. But it would have been a little closer.
Maybe take a map, possibly, like we saw CLG take it off Envious. Yeah. Always possible, unlikely, but possible. But anyway, going back into the groups now, and that's in Group B. That's the second first group stage match done today. So obviously, we're going to see Cloud9, the loser of the G2 versus Cloud9 match, face...
Method
now. Is it now or is it later? We don't know the schedule. 100%.
It also depends on the Russian TV station because they have a fixed schedule. And if it says, you know, at this and that time, the winner's match is going to go live, we have to flip the losers and the winner's match. But that's not that big of a deal.
Yeah. So we're either going to see the winner's match of Astralis versus G2, the old Titan lineup, come up next, or the loser's match between Method and Cloud9, which I think will be very interesting, in fact.
Yeah, and you're going to be the observer.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
That's going to be fun.
Yeah. Natasafix, obviously, big shout out to him.
Yeah, very
helpful. Taking over the observer role.
Yeah, Nato has been doing a lot of work today.
And to Petsa.
And to
Petsa. Our lovely producer.
Just talking in our headsets. Here,
yeah.
Yeah, I'm going to be observing the next game, so that should be fun. Hopefully, I won't mess it up too much. That should be very interesting to see. I haven't done observing for a while now.
Yeah.
But,
it is so hard. Really, it's easier to say it's bad than to make it better yourself because you have to watch all the different things and then you have to guess. You know, it's easy to spectate a CT because he will be faced with three players rushing in there. Yeah. But if you decide to go for the terrorists, you can get even cooler kills because the terrorists are running into the side and scanning everything and going for those RPK-like 1v4 clutch situations, for example. But yeah, I think there is not much to analyze about the previous matchup.
No, not
Astralis
really.
Astralis just expectedly stomped Method. So we will see them later on. And we are also going to see some commercial breaks. So thank you guys for tuning in. I'm The Boo. This is Hugo. Thank you for staying around.